I'm Rendon, and this is I'm Your Woman.
Not gonna be home tonight. You'll be all right.
So I'm Your Woman is a new movie from filmmaker Julia Hart, who made a movie last year, I believe, called Fast Color, which is a movie that a lot of people really liked and I thought was okay. That was a movie that had a lot going for it. It was really well done for the most part, but its budget was too small for what it was trying to accomplish. It was overly ambitious, and it ended up feeling a little bit amateur because of that. And the pace in it wasn't the best. But I said, you know what, there's enough in here to make me interested in this filmmaker. And now we have I'm Your Woman, which is an Amazon purchased and distributed movie. And it's really good. It's really good. On a second watch, I feel like this could jump up into the great movie category, because this is a movie that, although it's not super unique or unfamiliar, it does enough with its characters to be constantly engaging and have an incredibly satisfying third act.
Something happened tonight. You'll work out with Cal where you're gonna go.
Who the hell is Cal? Where is Eddie?
I'm Cal.
The biggest issue it has is its pacing, specifically in the first half. The first half is brutal. It's like this mess of fast-moving things and then really slow-moving things and characters jumping around, and it's really difficult to get involved with because it is so poorly paced. The first, like, 20 minutes moves at a breakneck pace to the point where I thought that was what the movie was gonna be. You have this girl, played by Rachel Brosnahan, I think. And the first thing we see is her sitting in her garden having an inner monologue, which is the only time you get an inner monologue, about her wanting to have a baby and then not having a baby. And then the next, literal next scene is her husband, a mob boss, walking in with a baby. And my first thought was, whose baby is that? The mob boss goes missing, and his wife, the main character, Rachel Brosnahan, has to go on the run. And that's essentially the story. You follow the wife of a mob boss on the run from another mob. And that's basically the bare bones rundown of the premise of this. It's pretty cookie cutter in terms of a crime drama, but I love the fact that it focuses very, very intently on its main character and the very few people that surround her. Again, the pacing is brutal. The first half is rough. Like I said, the first 20 minutes flies by, and then the next 40 or so is like montages of her taking care of her baby, intercut with occasional other people. It's really slow moving at a certain point, and it feels like the movie's on this roller coaster ride of this super high, and then the super low, and then near the halfway mark, it starts to plateau off at a pretty good level. Like, you're constantly going through a corkscrew, but not fast enough to where you're getting a stomach ache, but it's still fun. I don't know why a corkscrew for 45 minutes would be fun, but that just seemed like an okay thing to say. That was dumb.
Yes, I know what Eddie is. Is anybody looking?
Everyone's looking, and they're looking for you too.
Yeah, the movie does transform around the halfway mark after she escapes from her first house that she's hiding in. The movie really picks up, and the characters really pick up. There are characters introduced over halfway through the movie that are integral to the story. So the movie literally changes forms near the halfway mark. If I was to give the first half of this movie a rating, it'd be like a 6. Because it is generally well made. The structure of it is a little weak, but it looks great. It sounds great. I love the 70s period drama of this. I love the look of it. I love that era a lot. I love when a movie can set itself in that era. And the performances are generally good. It's just that first half has really nothing going for it because it wants to shroud its plot in secrecy. So that's why you get that first 20 minutes that are really quickly paced, because it's skipping over a lot of the details of how certain things are going on. And it lets the characters fill the audience in on that much later in the film. But because of that, there isn't a lot to latch onto in that first half. It just feels like it's being vague for no real reason, and you don't really get a good sense of who anybody is until the second half. The second half of this movie jumps from a 6 out of 10 to like an 8 or a 9. It is fantastic. The end of this movie is fantastic. She goes to another hiding place, another house, where she meets a whole band of new characters, and they are immediately infectious. I don't know what it was about all of these characters that she meets around this point, but every single one of them, I was like, please don't die. I love you too much. Rachel Bosnahan, this kind of handler of hers, Cal, and Cal's wife, Terry, who is kind of shrouded in secrecy because reasons. But those three characters are really the heart of the movie, the blood of the movie, and you get this really climactic ending with all three of them, and it was brilliantly handled. There was points in it where I was like glued to my seat, on the edge of my seat, and it's barely like any action is happening. There's a kind of bare bones car chase that happens, but the car chase isn't the interesting part of the action scene. It's what happens after the car chase that's the most interesting, because this movie really doubles down on the minutiae of the world. It really wants to get the audience in the character's head to think how they're thinking and how they're gonna handle it instead of, oh, action. And I love that approach. I think it's a fantastic second half to the movie. Unfortunately, the first half does bring it down quite a bit. It's actually hard to sit through, and at points I found myself doing anything else than watch that first half, because why would I need to watch two montages in a row of the wife caring for the baby for 20 minutes?
This can all be over.
But that said, I really like this movie. I'd probably give it a 7 on rewatch. It might jump up to an 8, I don't know. But it is one I would like to rewatch. I think it was really well done, really well made, really fun, great performances. Cool 70s period, great dialogue, not great pacing, okay structure, but a fantastic third act, an amazing, satisfying conclusion that I don't want to spoil, so just check it out. Bye-bye.